Hello, hello, hello. I am talking, and I'm alive and well. We are back with more of NBA 2K20's My Career Mode. Ugh, it's been literally, what, 10 years since I last played this. You guys know I've been uploading GTA 5 a lot lately. I've been doing the story mode, doing all the stuff in GTA Online. But we're back. We're back with more of NBA 2K20. And we're coming across close to the end of the regular season in My Career Mode. Better than in real life. But yeah, we're going to play this game here against Utah Jazz, and I wasn't even going to play this game beforehand because my last game was like against that crazy comeback against the Houston Rockets, I remember. We were down like, what, 23, and we came back in the second quarter at the end, and we blow them out at the end. But I wasn't going to film this one due to the fact of what was going on, you know, with Rudy Gobert, Donovan Mitchell. You know, they had the, I can't say that word. The COVID-19, we just say that, the COVID-19. But then, right before, I believe, around this date, March 26th, I think they were cleared by that time. So at least that's good. But because of that, we're going to go against them. And then we have Milwaukee. Here's the thing. All these games, I'm not even going to post up. Like, the Detroit one, I'm not going to post up. The Denver Nuggets, I'm not going to post that up. OKC, not going to post that up. I think, and Memphis too. So the only games we're going to pretty much, I'm going to upload is the teams that are basically going to make the playoffs in my career. So Utah, Milwaukee, Minnesota, Brooklyn, Houston Rockets. So the last recording game for my career is going to be the Houston Rockets game. And we're going to go straight into the playoffs after that. So yeah. Let's get this game and go in against Utah. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention this here too. As I'm filming this, it's April 13th. It's Mamba Day. How ironic that is, isn't it? That it's Mamba Day, I'm even rocking, my guy's rocking the Kobe shoes that he wore in his last game, the 413s. And hells, his last game was against the Utah Jazz. And he scored 60. So hells, why not go for 60? Now, here's Ingles. Taking a look at the scoring numbers, right now he averages about 9 points a game. To the paint, here's Conley. Nice chance. And touches with a clear path. I literally just stopped. Dropped my controller. Halfway. That's two slams in a row for Luka. Scoring dropped in 2 minutes and 54 seconds. I heard 2K fixed a patch that had something to do with alley-oops for our my players to finish. I heard they fixed it. We'll find out. As my phone just got an notification. Oh, that's a green. Mitchell. D. Mitch. I'm assuming this is also my first game as the 99 overall. Green, Luca.
Celtics stayed aggressive, and they have not let up this entire night. And at this point, I wouldn't expect them to. For the three, Utah getting another chance here.
Damn, we can't stop Gobert.
We know he brings it on the defensive end.
I'm pretty sure Boban, if he was still here, he would literally lock Gobert up.
Pass to Cleveland. Here's Powell on the wing. He dishes it to Hardaway. Jay, the pass to Hardaway. Jay.
From the logo! No. Call that again? Luka Magic from the logo. Luka, what was that from all season long? I'm right there. God, Mike. God, Mike. That's a yikes, Mike. I'm pretty sure this is the Mike Conley playing like at the beginning of the season in real life. Didn't he struggle at the start? There we go. Yikes, start over. I hate that animation so bad. I try to go for a charge. Hey, it worked. It worked. I try to go for a charge. Oh, I thought he had that. How the hell did Rudy got it behind him? There you go, he repeated himself. And one. Oh, I was going to do the dab. No! Connection just went down. This is the problem I had. Especially when I played GTA, yeah, these are the problems. Okay, take two. But the stupid fucking connection just ruined that. Watch. Because of that, the Utah Jazz are going to be playing better. They're going to be playing better. I'm calling it. Calling it right now.
Hello and thanks for joining us. And no check. See you.
I'm pissed. The connection want to fuck me. How about this? I'm mad. Mama mentality.
He's brought his points per game average up thanks to the work he's done in the past 10, and maybe he's got another big one in store tonight. The starters for the Utah Jazz. Inside, we have Ingles and Gobert. And then runs the point with Mitchell flanking him. And it's Bogdanovich in at the
I'm mad right now.
For Dallas, Doncic and Porzingis, the incredible forward pair. Tim Hardaway Jr. out there with Jay. And it's Powell in at the center position. And now what's great tonight, we have two teams that love to push the tempo, love the pace. Smitty, do you like the fact the NBA is getting faster?
No, I like it, Kevin. What I don't like is coming down and taking a shot, an ill-advised shot. There's nothing wrong with playing fast, getting the ball up to court. If you don't have an advantage or a high percentage shot, just bring it out and run your offense.
Stay within the offense.
Yeah, stay within the offense. Gobert can't hit. Three straight misses to begin this contest. It already starting to look frustrated.
Jay, that drop shot comes off the assist from Hardaway.
Look, this is how you draw it up coming out of the locker room. 3 of 3 so far.
Yeah, because we're furious right now, bro.
Now here's Conley. 8 points his last outing. Lays it up off the glass.
And Conley, because of his quickness and wingspan, he plays bigger than his size.
Pass to Porzingis. Inside. And it takes that one up and powers it through.
And how about that? What a sensational finish.
Hey, you got to be able to get some hang time to do that. For Utah, they've gone just 1 of 4 to get this game started. Conley, the pass to Mitchell. Jazz passing it around. And Bogdanovich kicks to Conley. And there's the pass to Ingles. Just 5 on the clock. Pulls up. High post. The shot, no good. And it's Dallas the other way.
They are out of rhythm. 1 for 5 so far. You just need to calm down and
Damn. Reward
your matchups. And you want more of this from Doncic.
Yo, this is the same score from before. Call that timeout.
And so it's Utah here with the ball. Following the score by Dallas, Gobert finds Mitchell.
Wait, hold on. Hold up a second, guys. Alright, we're back. I didn't notice that the audio was so loud. It's because I was in the party chat. Damn, because of that connection, it ruined all those highlights that were so good. Especially that Luka deep three from the logo. What? I'm not here like flight. I'm not flight missing wide open layups. Here's the thing, that's one of the reasons why I stopped playing for a bit is because the connection problems. And I've had those problems like that in GTA Online. I had that when I was like doing like what? Heist setup missions for the casino heist. It's hard. How the hell did we swap? There was no reason to switch right there. But I figured, hey, he doesn't miss. Let's just put Rudy on him. That is ridiculous.
That's the 3 fly.
What? Can't even get rebounds. I'm disgusted. Boban would stop those. Damn, I was out of stamina. I was out of stamina, and yet I still made that in. I just really did that. Who is that guy's dump packages I have? Wow, this ain't the dunk contest. That weak out of here, bro. I told you, we're furious. I'm furious. I might have to throw the highlights. I just want to throw like all the highlights that happened in the first attempt. And I'll save in the game around halftime if it happens again. I thought I was going to get the takeover, lose the takeover and get myself a turnover. So I immediately just put on takeover. Another shot clock cheese from Luka. I wish it would have been from the logo again. Down by 15. Yikes.
Up to the right wing. A three. That's good from Moutier on the assist from Green.
The defense decides to gamble off him, and he cashes in.
What is that animation? I've never seen that before. Did they nerf my crossover moves? Two things that held them back are turnovers and poor free throw shooting.
another one for the Jams. Smitty Schneider, also an All-American in high school, two-time Washington State Basketball Player of the Year in high school.
He led Mercer Island to his state title, and then experienced coaching in college, the G League, and abroad. He's a lifer, and he's been around.
Why did we have us forced to switch? Why? I'm defending my guy, and oh yeah, and all of a sudden I'm back to my guy. And we can't even grab rebounds. I'm disappointed. Boban would have stopped that, but no, he's injured. I'm out here like flight. Give me that. Bro, this is one not a close game the first time. Watch they come back and we lose the lead when I'm on the bench. It's a close game. Okay. Damn. Luka made him look like a fool. I don't think I made 1-3 in this game. Exactly the first three of the game and the second attempt. Still 3 of 5, 6 points, but minus 15. Damn, you guys have no respect for Rudy, huh?
Six over right, and again it's Utah.
And look at it, a significant portion of their offense coming on those second chance opportunities.
Gobert brings the double team. And the whistle blows, it's going to be on Michael Conley. That'll be his second foul of the game.
His second foul in as many quarters. We'll see if he backs off or stays aggressive.
Shots good from Jay.
I mean, the number of points they scored in the paint already here is eye opening.
And it's Conley with the ball for the Jazz. 15-point game. Atlanta will be traveling to face them after this. That's the first game in a string of three straight at home. And Utah again with the bucket.
Hey, at least Mike is playing better than he is in this game than the first time. Better, because I have a double-double in the first half. I don't think I had that the first attempt. Get the fuck out of here! Oh, he already made that one? Okay. I don't think I had that block.
Terrific read by Gobert, understanding the offensive end better and better, especially as of late.
Doncic outside, stolen by Conley. Here's Green, and that one falls, coming off Conley's feet. Conley's got 4 assists in the game. Dallas leading by 9. Here's Jay.
Oh, come on. Even behind his back, I can't even. They're going for the throat. Damn right. Right play clamps on James Harden, I remember. And I was doing the same thing on Mitchell. Alright, 75-64. Alright, when we hit the halftime mark, I gotta have to score and then save. Or they will score. I have to. Hey, 24, first half. That's not good. I had scored 31 the first time.
And after a very lopsided first half, we'll see if things play out a little more evenly here in the second. It's been one outstanding game from Jay.
Well, with a double-double in hand for 2 quarters, you can just imagine what his stat line will look like at the end of this. They're asking a lot of him, shouldering the load in a number of areas. You just hope he has enough left at the end. So, it's a sight to see, incredible at scoring in a variety of ways.
Okay, saving it right here, and then come back. And we're back. Dude, because of this, I have 24 points. That is not good. The first time I had 31.
It's a 13-point game. We've got a little looks at the floor. Once you buy it here, it all fueled up for the second half. On the floor right now for the Mavericks. Inside with the floor. 4 and 5 for Zingas inbound. Hardaway is out there with Jay, and it's Doncic into the hoop. On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Well, Jay in that last matchup against the Rockets delivered quite a performance. He had an impressive number of points, and he got those points as he always does, knocking down shots from beyond the arc. It's rare to see any player put up numbers like that. It's likely a game no offers for him.
It's going to be interesting to see how he follows up that performance.
Yeah, he was the driving force behind that victory, but each night comes with a different challenge.
What you should say, the Jazz are what they call a pipeline team. And what does that mean? It means they have to draft and develop their talent internally.
Now here's Gobert. He has six. Mitchell looking it over. Pocket six. Outside Conley, got a piece of it, but he gets a pin, and there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time.
Don't test me.
Doncic passes to Porzingis. Jay, over by Conley. Outside Hardaway. No good from outside. And the Jazz say they need a fundamentally sound process to building their roster. Doris, no shortcuts.
Well, there's no question about that. This is a group that has to be value space for their free agent acquisitions in a small market. The draft picks have got to be smart. Their teaching and cultivating of that talent and development is absolutely critical.
On the wing, Mitchell. Off target from the wing. Just under 2.5 minutes into the third quarter now. And that one drops. And the Mavericks lead by 17.
Yeah, Kevin, he has proven to be a quality finisher off the pick and roll. Dwight Powell can adjust midair to get his shot.
Here's Jay, and he goes in for the dunk.
Well, let's go home. That was just ridiculous.
I do not remember the last time I saw a dunk like that in a game. Now here's Conley. He's got 11. Gobert finds Mitchell. And it's Bogdanovich in the corner. Fires for three. Buries the long-range jumper. Bogdanovich has got five.
Well, to me, this is what great point guards do. Donovan Mitchell demonstrating just how skilled he is at connecting with open teammates.
Over in the corner, Doncic. And stolen by Bogdanovich.
Fuck, I got three turnovers.
Here's Conley. Powell pulls it in.
They're going to need more from this guy if they're going to cut into this deficit.
Doncic with it. Conley picks him up. Dallas moving the ball around. Jay is covered by Bogdanovich. Back to Doncic. Down to five on the shot clock. Pass to Jay. There's the triple. Brooks. This is goes to Doncic. 34 points for Jay.
Well, I absolutely love the way this guy has controlled tonight. They've been able to head off injury for their players. They believe this gives them a clearer picture into the overall health of their athletes.
Looking at who's out there now for the Mavericks. Maxi Kleba is checked in for Dwight Powell. Justin Jackson comes in for Porzingis as Jalen Brunson in for Luka Doncic. Hits it from three-point range. 5 points in the game.
Well, Dante Exum knocking down shots will put a smile on this team's face. He continues to work on the offensive end.
He endorses those blood tests you were talking about, always subject to player permission. They want to honor player privacy.
I think you have to, Kevin, and most of the Mavs have embraced it. These tests have the ability to measure almost 50 biomarkers. As an athlete, you're always trying to stay in peak form. As an organization, you're always trying to manage appropriately their workloads.
The first one falls. But you can't help but notice that teams are shooting earlier in the shot clock. One theory being the faster you shoot, the more possessions you get.
Well, numbers quickly speak. No, no doubt, Kevin. The reality is, for announcers and for fans, that breakneck pace makes it more exciting for us. One NBA coach told me this past year, that your field goal percentage in the first 10 seconds of shot clock gives you your best opportunity to make it. And the longer that shot clock goes on, the more your field goal percentage dips. So, hey, good for us, good for the fans, good for the teams.
And that's because the defense has a chance to shut, correct?
Exactly right.
So it's the Mavericks now, after Ed Davis' steal. Jay, the pass to Jackson. And he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. The 15th pick back in 2017, Justin Jackson, Doris. The Jackson Jones here. So it's the Mavericks now. A 21-point lead, the biggest in the game. Here's Jay. On target with his three. Utah's got the three-pointer to fall to the tune of 50% here in the third quarter. They've made 3 of 6. There's Boudier. Green breaking loose. Controls the rebound and puts it back up and in.
Yeah, how about the snap-to-it-tickness on that possession? Stayed with it, didn't give up until the ball was in the basket.
Boudier brings the double team. Here's White. A rebound by the Jams. Davis has got his 7th rebound of the game with that last one. Exum, 5 points in the game. He's looking for Mitchell and finds him. Good work there as it goes. Mitchell's got 22.
I tell you, when Donovan Mitchell starts to cook, you might as well sit back and enjoy the show.
What? Yeah,
good that time either. Jazz trail by 17. And here's Boudier. 12 points for him. Inside, Davis.
Dude, I couldn't even imagine having a green release three and get missed. I would literally would close out. Oh, he didn't take the shot, but it doesn't matter. He didn't take the three.
Well, we see a de-emphasis of the mid-range shot opportunities in today's NBA, but Porzingis excels in that area.
Conley with it. 11 points in the game. Porzingis with the block. Fast break, Dallas. On the wing, Doncic. To Porzingis, it's good.
Guys, how about that pocket control from Porzingis? You think it's easy at 7'3" to gut your way through that kind of contact? That's nice.
Dan Green is really expected. Porzingis getting a huge deal from Dallas to keep him a man for a long time.
Max feel he can be better than he was before the injury. Love the idea of pairing him long term with Doncic. Sign into a lengthy and sizable deal to be the core of their future.
The officials of Kyle
How many points was that? 41? So there are like 19 more?
And with as many three-pointers as they bring, it's easy to see why they're on the cusp of a blowout. And we'll be back with you shortly.
Stranger Things.
Extremely well. 62% of the night to this point. And Utah, look at who they've got to start the fourth quarter. They got Joe Ingles. Williams Goss is out there with Harrison. That's Onita. And it's the end in power forward position.
And with the lead, I like the strategy here. Continue to get the ball to guys who can do something with it.
One thing we've learned in the NBA, the game is never over. So you've got to continue to score.
His third foul of the game.
You know what? You've got to always be in control of your emotions.
Jackson is checked in for the Mavericks. Time it goes. Jamming that one home.
The big finish in front.
He hangs on the rim just for good measure.
So you think the ownership style of the Mavericks, something the league had to adjust to. Very active, very outspoken. Sometimes I think that rubbed people the wrong way. Get the sense it's almost the new normal.
Pass to Williams Goss. Pass to Harrison. Just find the shoot. Flying his work from deep. Doesn't go for him. And the Mavericks going the other way. The Mavericks, we know, have been trendsetters, investing in development. Technology.
Kevin, they have always been on the cutting edge of data collection and then using that data to give them a competitive advantage. When you're in a business, it's always about what's next, how can I be better?
Here's Williams Goss. Passes to Harrison over Berea. No good, they had a chance to end the run there. And so it's Jackson who brings it up with an air. Here on the fourth quarter, the defense has been very strong, allowing no passes.
11.
Well, I like here, even with the big lead, they continue to execute their offense.
And that, to me, Greg, is a sign of excellent coaching. There's an attention to detail. There is valuing of every possession.
Boy, you can just see the frustration growing on their faces. Nothing going their way.
It's just been one of those games, and they need to find a way to turn it around before it gets completely away from them. I'll tell you, this lead's not going anywhere with this guy making plays. What a quarter.
They've been struggling here on offense.
Yeah, a bit of a dry spell for sure.
There's Harrison, guarded by Berea. No good on the shot, so the Mavericks will take it the other way. Here's Chase.
Should I go for the easy route?
Right now,
just take threes? Or should I just go for the twos?
Here's O'Neal.
Bulls.
There's the three. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. Powell's got 10 rebounds here tonight. So active. Here's Murray. And another assist for him.
That makes 15 assists.
He's been one step ahead of the defense all game long. Harrison scanning the floor. Pass to Williams-Gauntz. From deep. The shot by Harrison, no good.
Let's give some credit to the defense for how they're guarding this guy right now, because they're refusing to let him get comfortable.
Here's Jay. Stolen away. That's right, here come the chance. Here's Harrison, guarded by Berea. Williams draws the pass to Harrison. Great team that time from Jay.
Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
Well, not at the offensive end, certainly. He cannot buy a bucket right now.
Back to Murray. Over to the wing. Just four to shoot. Dallas needs to get off a shot. Berea, the pass to Powell. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. And some changes here for the Mavericks. Maxi Kleber comes in for Dwight Powell. And it's Seth Curry in for J.J. Barrett. Utah also making some changes. Green comes in for Joe Ingles. And it's Exum in for Harrison.
Well, you get exactly what you want right there. Clean look, right at the cup. Nicely done.
Here are the Mavericks going. They're on a 19-4 run. Dallas again.
Oh, come on. Five fucking turnovers, Cook. Damn, the game doesn't want to even let me get take turnovers. They don't leave me alone. Get that weak out of here. Over.
And so it's Exum with it.
I don't even need the ball no more.
Rebounded by Jackson. Jackson's got his fifth rebound in this one. For a three, Murray, another three.
Look, yeah, they even hitting threes with Murray. At the game.
Here are these defensive coaches in our meetings for us talk about their players staying on the string, hoping to help defenders in this league are important.
No doubt. And there are certain guys who are gifted defensively. Paul George, to me, was a defensive player in the year category. Rudy Gobert, multi-time center of the defensive player of the year. Rudy is considered a great shot blocker, and no question that's the case. But it's because his defensive rotation is so good. Guys like Marcus Smart, the ones willing to give up their body, fly around the floor, be great anticipators. I mean, that impacts winning.
They're fun to watch.
So fun.
at two. The shot by Curry, no good. Utah has gone ice cold from three-point land, 0-4 since the start of the final quarter. Williams guards the pass to Niang. Situation. Passes it to Niang. Another miss by Utah.
They have been bored and dominant in this game. That's definitely been a factor in cracking this huge lead.
Good on the shot.
Well, you know that Seth Curry will be aggressive regardless of where he is on the floor. Nice look inside there.
Williams guards the pass to Green. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line. And Jeff Greenwald, a journeyman veteran in the NBA. Of course, he'll give you good production.
It doesn't matter what position you play this guy. Jeff Green finds a way to contribute. Listen, I know his three-point shooting can be hot and cold, but this guy is aware of when to look for it and when to move the basketball. Two qualities you love.
Courtney Lee is checked in for Curry. Andrew Harrison's checked in for Utah. On the wing, Jackson. He dishes it to Murray. That time from Green.
Not a great decision there. The defender in your grill can't get out.
Got it. Number 7 on the night. 7 for 11 from the floor.
Boy, the consistency he's had tonight has been impressive. Really steady from the field.
Jay, the best in league. Here's Cleveland. Out to Lee. Here's the 3. That one doesn't go. Now the Jazz take it the other way. Here's Harrison, covered by Lee. From the baseline. And Lee pulls it down. Dallas has gone 3-4 from downtown here in the fourth. On the pass to Jay. Lee outside. The 3. The rebound by Jeff Green. Green's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Puts it up from 12. And the rebound goes to the Mavericks. Jackson's got 6 rebounds now in the game. Jay, the pass to Lee. Another possession. Another assist. Dishing it all over the place in this one.
I'm not even, like, I'm just going to pass it.
50 left in the fourth quarter. Here's Harrison, guarded by Jackson. Harrison passes to Niang. The Jazz working the ball around now from about 19 feet, and it's good off the back of the rim and in. Williams-Goss has got 6 in the quarter. Williams-Goss has gone 3-for-4 from the floor tonight. Murray kicks to Cleveland. Lee outside. To Cleveland. To the inside. He doesn't hit that one. Great T that time for Green.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Mavericks.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often, but tonight this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And one thing about this team, they never stopped pushing the envelope. Fantastic year already with 65 wins, and tonight making it 66. Very impressive.
And bragging rights between these teams were on the line today, and they put in some very good work to earn.
And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Jay.
Well, unselfish basketball. His ability to create for others has been the story of this game.
You know what I'm going for.
Separating the shot game clocks. They turn over the 24-second buzzer, signaling the shot clock.
Gotta do it. honor of the Mamba.
Here's Harrison.
So we see hey, did it.
This game may not have been the most exciting we've ever seen, but they have to appreciate just what a clinical performance they put on.
I know their fans appreciated it. We saw at times just stretches of excellent defense. Potency from an offensive standpoint.
Scored 60 on Mamba Day. 99.9. And of course it was on Hall of Fame.